Shall we learn the Chirao dance?
Good evening, Grandma. This sweater looks very pretty.
Thank you, Meenu. I'm knitting this for you. You will look very pretty in this. Where are you all going?
We are going to the garden to play, Grandma. Do you also want to come with us?
All right. I don't have much work now. I will also come to see you play.
Grandma, a new boy joined school today. He is our friend now. He will also come to play with us.
New friend? That's nice. From where has he come?
I will show you the place on the map, Grandma. Look, he is from this state. He is from the state of Mizoram. His name is Tomcha.
Tomcha is a nice name. Buzz, you are getting smarter now. Can you tell me the names of the states that are near Mizoram?
I will have to look at the map carefully.
Buzz, look here. This is Manipur. This is Assam. And this is Tripura.
Oh, so there are three states near Mizoram. But look, there is Bangladesh also. What is that?
Buzz, Bangladesh is a different country.
I see, it's a different country. Look, Mizoram is at the tip. But there are other states also. What are they?
Buzz, there is an interesting name for these states in the northeastern part of India.
Northeastern part? How?
Look, this is the map of India. These states are on the eastern side of India. They are also in the northern part of India. That's why we call them northeastern part of India.
Oh, like that. North and eastern. So, northeastern. Meenu, what is the interesting name?
They are called the Seven Sisters.
Seven Sisters? But why?
Because there are seven states there. Look at the map. Meghalaya, Assam, Arunachal Pradesh, Nagaland, Manipur, Mizoram, and Tripura. These are the seven states and they are called the Seven Sisters.
Oh, what an interesting name. I will tell Tomcha also. He will think I am very smart.
Don't worry. I will tell him that you don't know anything.
Grandma, look at Chinu. He is making fun of me. I know so many things now.
Okay, stop fighting, both of you. Look, our friends are all there. I can see Sahil, Sheila, Salim and Peter too.
Look, Tomcha is also here. Hello everybody.
Hello Chinu. Hello Meenu.
Tomcha, this is our grandmother.
Good evening, Grandma.
Good evening, Tomcha. So, you are the new friend. You look so sweet. When did you come to our village?
We came here only yesterday, Grandma. My father works for a bank. He got transferred from Aizwal to this place.
Aizwal? Where is that?
Buzz, Aizwal is the capital of Mizoram. He was working in a bank there. Now, he is transferred to this village.
So, he will work in the village bank now.
We will also stay in the village.
That is why he has joined our school, Grandma. Tomcha, do many children go to school in Mizoram?
almost all children go to school in Mizoram. In many places, there are no roads at all. We have only hilly paths. There are lots of forests in Mizoram. Sometimes, children have to go through forests to reach their school. But still, most of the children go to school.
I know. I read it in a book. After Kerala, it is Mizoram where most of the children go to school.
Kerala? Where is Kerala? What happens there?
Buzz, look. This is Kerala. Almost everyone in this state can read and write. Every child in this state goes to school.
Oh, that's really good. Many people in our village cannot read or write.
That's right. Every state should become like Kerala or Mizoram. Everyone should go to school and learn to read and write.
Tomcha, did you go to school with your friends?
Yes, Bas. I had lots of friends. We used to walk to our school. We used to sing and dance on our way to school.
We also love going to school. Even I like singing on my way to school. We go through fields. Then we go in a line.
Sometimes the crop is as tall as us. We run touching them with one hand. Then they start swaying.
Tomcha, do crops in the fields of Mizoram also grow as tall as they grow here?
They do. But sometimes the fields are just empty.
Fields are just empty? How can that be? Don't farmers grow anything in the field?
They do. But sometimes the fields are empty. That is because in Mizoram we do jhum farming.
Jhum farming? What is that? What do you do in jhum farming?
I know about jhum farming. It is a type of farming, Buzz. In jhum farming, the farmer grows his crop in the field. After harvesting the crop, he leaves the land as it is for some years. Nothing is grown there.
Nothing is grown there, Grandma. The field is left empty.
Grandma is right. The field is left empty. That is why I said that sometimes fields are empty.
When the fields are left empty, then some weeds or bamboo grow there on their own. Even these are not pulled out. The farmers cut these weeds or bamboo and burn them. The ash that remains after burning makes the land fertile.
But Grandma, Tomcha said that there are lots of forests in Mizoram. What if the fire spreads and destroys the trees? Isn't it dangerous?
No, Meenu. The farmers take a lot of care while burning the weeds or bamboo. They burn it very carefully so that the fire does not spread to the other parts of the forest.
That's right. The farmer checks if the field is fertile and is ready for farming. Then the farmer lightly digs up the field.
Digs the field? Doesn't he plow the field, Grandma?
No, Chinu. The field is not plowed. It is only lightly dug up. The farmer then drops seeds on the field.
Yes, my friend's father is a farmer in Mizoram. So, I used to go with him and drop seeds in their field. They grow different type of crops on one farm itself.
Different types of crops? Like what?
Like rice,
maize, vegetables, chilies, and other things. Again, the weeds that grow along with the crops are not pulled out. They are just cut and left there. They mix with the soil and keep the soil fertile.
That's a good idea. The weeds mix with the soil to make the soil fertile.
Tomcha, you said different crops are grown in Mizoram. But what is the main crop that is grown there?
The main crop is rice. Lots of rice is grown in Mizoram. When it is harvested, it is very difficult to take it home.
I know why. You said that in many places there are no roads. There are only hilly paths. It must be very difficult to carry big bags of rice on those hilly paths.
You are right. That's why people carry the crop on their backs. It takes many weeks to carry all the crop back.
Tomcha, do you have any special celebration for harvest? In our village, the whole village joins together. We cook and eat together. People are so happy that they sing and dance.
We do the same thing in Mizoram. We also cook and eat together. We sing songs. We do a special dance. It is called the Shero dance.
Shero dance? How do you do that?
In this dance, people sit in pairs in front of each other. They hold the two ends of the bamboo sticks on either side and keep it on the ground. Then some people beat the drums. As the drum beats, the bamboo sticks are beaten to the ground. Then dancers step in and step out of the bamboo sticks and dance to the beat of the drums.
Ooh, I have seen this dance on TV. It is very beautiful. I have seen the dancers step beautifully to the beat of the drum. They must do it carefully or else they can get hurt.
Did you notice something? All the things people use are the ones that are available in their region. In Mizoram, there is lots of bamboo. So, they use it for their chirao dance. In Jharkhand, they make plates from the leaves of sal tree.
Yes, Grandma. Every place has a special thing. Meenu, we should also learn the chirao dance and do it for our school function next month.
Next month? But I will not be here in the village. Why will you not be here, Gopi? Where are you going?
Oh, Tomcha, Gopi will go with his parents to another place for about 5 months. Many families from our village go away like that. There will not be any rains for the next few months. And so, there is no work in the fields.
So, they will leave their many tins of land and go to another place.
Tins of land? What do you mean by that, Tomcha? I have never heard of tins of land.
Oh, in Mizoram, we measure land like that. If we grow one tin of seeds in a piece of land, we call it one tin of land. If three tins of seeds can be grown in a piece of land, it is called three tins of land. Don't you call the land like that?
No, our land is measured in bighas. It is called one bigha of land or two or three bighas of land. It is different from yours.
Yes, children. Land is measured differently in different places. In some places, it is measured in Rupani and other places in Katha.
Oh, so it is different from ours. Even who gets how much land to cultivate every year is different for us.
Who gets how much land to cultivate is different? How can that be, Tomcha?
Oh, I know about it, Chino. I know how it is different in Mizoram villages. All the land in the village belongs to everyone. Every year, the village panchayat draws a lottery. Each family takes out a chit from a big bamboo bowl one by one. Then, different tins of land are distributed to different families based on what they get in the chit. For that year, a family has to cultivate so many tins of land as they get in the chit that they take out.
This is wonderful, Grandma. The land belongs to the whole village, so people don't have to fight for land. They get to cultivate a different piece of land every year.
That's right, Meenu. They cultivate that piece of land that they get in the lottery. Grandma, you were telling us that many families leave the village for some months when there is no rain. Where do they go?
They go to other villages where sugarcane is grown. They go there with their families.
Grandma, how will sugarcane grow? You said that there will be no rainfall.
Sugarcane farming can be done when there is no rainfall, Buzz. But Grandma, if our village can get enough water, will they have to move out?
No, Chino. But our village should have a good irrigation system for our fields. There are different methods of irrigation like canals, tube wells or water wheels. When I was small, we used to have water wheels in our village. And we enjoyed playing in the water.
Grandma, I also play in the tube well in Papa's field. It is so much fun.
But if Gopi goes with his parents for some months, won't he miss school?
Yes, that is a big problem. Many children miss school during these months. Sometimes a teacher also moves with them and teaches them during that time. But not always. So, they all miss school.
That is why I have told the panchayat that I will form a group of grandmothers and grandfathers. We do not move with our family. So, all of us together can take care of all the children in the village. The parents can leave them back here and go. Then, they don't have to miss school. They can work hard and do well in life.
That's a good idea, Grandma. You can be the leader of the group. Friends, do your parents also go to other places for some months for a job? Do you also go with them? Do you miss school during that time? Why don't you talk to your teachers and elders in your village so that you can continue your school?
Shall we help Parrot fill in the blanks now? The states of and are called the Seven Sisters. A Arunachal Pradesh. Assam, Manipur, Mizoram,
Nagaland, Tripura, Meghalaya.
The states of Arunachal Pradesh, Assam, Manipur, Mizoram, Nagaland, Tripura, and Meghalaya are called the Seven Sisters. Is the capital of Mizoram. Aizwal is the capital of Mizoram. Is the only state that has 100% literacy. Kerala is the only state that has 100% literacy. Farming is done in Mizoram. Jhoom farming is done in Mizoram. The people of Mizoram do a special dance called the Cherao dance. The people of Mizoram do a special dance called the Cherao dance. The main crop grown in Mizoram is rice. The main crop grown in Mizoram is rice. Land in Mizoram is measured by tins. Land in Mizoram is measured by tins. And are different methods of irrigation. Canals. Tube wells. Water wheel. Canals, tube wells, and water wheel are different methods of irrigation. Will you help Rabbit to find out whether the following statements are true or false? Farmers in Mizoram get land to cultivate every year through a lottery. True. Wheat is the main crop grown in Mizoram. False. There is lots of bamboo in Mizoram. True. Mizoram is a state in South India. False. Sugarcane can be grown when there is no much rainfall. True. Jhoom farming is done in Kerala. False. Now let us give very short answers to these questions. Friends, will you also answer with me? Where is the state of Mizoram? In the northeastern part of India. Capital of Mizoram. Aizwal. What are the 7 states in the northeastern part of India called? Sisters. Dance of Mizoram. Cherao dance. Farming of Mizoram. Jhum farming. Main crop of Mizoram. Rice. Land measured in Mizoram by 10s. To whom does farming land belong to in Mizoram? To the whole village and not separate people. In Mizoram, who will cultivate what land is decided by lottery. Different methods of irrigation. Canal, tube well, or water wheels. Friends, now you know how the bamboo sticks are kept for Cherao dance. I want to draw it now. Will you also draw it along with me? Friends, let us now answer these questions. You can write the answers in your notebook also. Can you name the 7 states that are called as 7 sisters? Meghalaya, Assam, Arunachal Pradesh, Nagaland, Manipur, Mizoram, and Tripura. Do you know what Mizoram and Kerala have in common? Almost every child goes to school in both these states. How is jhum farming done? In jhum farming, the field is left empty after harvesting a crop. Bamboo or weeds that grow are not pulled out. They are cut and burnt. This ash makes the land fertile. When the field is ready for farming, it is lightly dug up and not ploughed. Seeds are then dropped in the field. What kind of crops can be grown in such a field? In one field, different types of crops like maize, rice, chilies, or vegetables can be grown. How do farmers in Mizoram celebrate after harvesting their crop? village celebrates together. They cook, eat, sing, and dance together. They do a special dance called the Cherao dance. How is the Cherao dance performed? In this dance, the dancers sit in pairs in front of each other. They hold the two ends of the bamboo sticks on either side and keep it on the ground. The bamboo sticks are beaten on the ground to the beat of drums. The dancers step in and step out of the bamboo sticks as they dance to the beat of drums. How do farmers in Mizoram measure their land? Farmers in Mizoram measure their land in tins. For example, the land on which one tin of seed can be grown is called one tin of land. The land on which two tins of seeds can be grown is two tins of land, and so on. Is land measured in tins everywhere? No, land is measured differently in different places. In some places, it is measured in bigas. In other places, it is measured in ropani and katha. Do you know how land is measured in the place where you live? Find out!